And it is Water Cooler Wednesday.
Yes, it is. Here today, Danny Bruns from 98.1 The Max, Steve Connolly with 99.3 Guess FM, and Miramichi Golf Course, and our own Todd Demers.
From the weather section.
Oh.
I don't have a really cool title like these guys.
You have it now. Our weather expert.
It's the first day of summer, so you're the man today, okay?
Good to have you guys
just
here.
Today.
Thanks for having me.
All right.
Okay, following the death of Otto Warmbier, some travel companies taking Americans to North Korea are now rethinking those plans. The White House is considering banning tourist travel to the country altogether. And Arizona Senator John McCain says Americans, I'm quoting here, stupid enough to go to North Korea should now be required to sign a waiver absolving the U.S. government of any blame if they're harmed while there. So, yeah?
I saw this yesterday. I thought it was great.
His quote is perfect
because when I was that age, or younger adult, I thought I was invincible. I think we all go through that. But I didn't think I was that invincible. Who says, hey, I'm just going to get on a plane, go over to North Korea because I think I can? Or whose parents allow them to go do that? If you are stupid enough to go over there, then yes, sign something, and we're not responsible for you.
Don't
Good
candy
luck.
Coat it here at all. Go ahead, tell us really how you feel about this, Danny.
Maybe you could be a little more diplomatic. These parents did just lose their
The boy died. I think there's a little bit of sensitivity. Maybe it's not smart, not stupid to, you know, I understand that as well. You just don't, kids that wandered into Afghanistan or whatever. We've heard those stories. So unless you're in a reporting status, highly advised not to do that.
Because of that story, if you still want to go, then you're stupid. I'm not trying to make this kid who died was stupid,
right.
But with all this in the news, now you are stupid if you go.
You see the danger that's already there,
right.
And so going there, you're kind of like doing so at your own peril. So I kind of agree with all of that as far as what the senator is saying. Not necessarily the word stupid so much, but as far as certainly unadvisable. I didn't even know that we were allowed to go there. I thought you had to have certain diplomatic papers before you go there, but there's one basketball player that seems to have a red carpet laid out for him there every day. So,
that's all people.
But
all
boy, right. I would just say pass.
We will keep it moving here. Our campaign is underway in Colorado to make it the first state to ban sales of smartphones for children. A proposed ballot initiative wouldn't make it illegal for stores to sell smartphones to kids under 13 or to adults who intend to give the phones to preteens. The proposal would continue to allow sales of basic cell phones for kids, just not smartphones with all the games and apps. So would you, Steve Connolly, support this measure?
You got kids right around that age.
They're all over 13, though. Man.
Yeah. And
so you're legal.
Coming up.
Steve,
on
are you trying to deflect attention here?
I'm deflecting,
here?
Yes. Now, it's a responsibility now. It goes beyond just having a phone in your hand. It goes way beyond that. So I think it ought to be 21 years old and not just 13.
Wow.
No, I think that you should not sell it to kids 13 and under.
Shouldn't you leave the parents?
Yes.
I mean,
but the parents should buy it for the kid.
Well, yeah.
I think they're going to do that. Whether
parents should be smarter, but be grieved. Do we need a law?
Yeah, part of that.
I can't imagine a 12-year-old walking in AT&T and say, "Hey, I want a phone."
And Todd, part of the debate is from one of the organizers. He says children seem to change. They are, they become more into themselves. They don't spend time outside. They lose their social skills.
I agree with that totally. They've talked about addictions to these phones as well, starting at a very early age. I support that, but I have no way of believing anybody would ever be able to enforce that, whether it's by a law or a parent who has a child who says, everybody else has one, I want one of them. Okay, here you go. So I think it's a great idea. I understand the concerns, but I don't think there'd be ever a way to enforce it.
Yeah. I think they should have age-appropriate phones. I think if you could make phones with that dial and text.
Like just call your mom.
Just call your mom, and then I know you can remove some apps, but if they could sell age-appropriate phones, leave it in the hands of the parents. But I would like that as my kids got older. Hey, this is appropriate for you. You get the 10-year-old phone. You get the 12, 15.
Yeah, okay. That'd be cool.
All right.
So you get a flip phone.
Yes,
Steve, because you don't know how to use it. All right, well, you may not even want a smartphone after this. Facebook has apparently applied for a patent for new technology that would allow them to use your smartphone camera to take your picture as you scroll on your page. And they'd then be able to use the image to determine your mood and use that. It would affect the kind of stories that they put in your timeline. So if they see you're happy, like they'll put more of those kinds of stories. Facebook says they frequently apply for patents for technology that they never use, so they say don't be all concerned. Todd, what do you think?
Well, I am kind of concerned. Anytime I'm hearing something about they're watching me through the camera on my phone and I don't know about it, I'm a little bit unnerved. So hopefully, if they're going after this technology, which I am sure there are going to be some people on Facebook that thinks this is the greatest thing since sliced bread, mm-hmm. but I want to have that option. You better be able to say, Todd, do you want us to be able to do this or not? And, you know, I'll click the no picture and then everybody else can go have a good time. But I think it's interesting technology, the way things are evolving.
So, Danny, too invasive or do you
can
like
I have
it?
That flip phone, Mary Beth. Yeah.
Oh, you're going old school here.
That gave me the willies.
What I think will happen, honestly. Consumers will go.
Yeah, I don't want anybody seeing me. And I always think it's interesting when I see my doctor. She has a Band-Aid over her camera when she's going over everything on her iPad.
Oh.
And because she doesn't, my husband does the same thing. They cover up the camera. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I don't want anybody seeing my face doing
okay,
anything.
Where is the camera?
right up there.
Oh. Hold your finger right there, would you? Come on, right here.
I put this into Snopes. I thought it was a ridiculous one of those things you get passed down on Facebook.
So you didn't believe us?
I didn't believe it. I actually looked it up, and supposedly, yes, they can do that, but it's just a little bit, like you said, invasive, and, you know, the genie's out of the bottle now, and technology is just run rampant to the point where it's frightening in some mm-hmm. ways. And if that's all true, right. If that's the case, that, you know, the guys at Facebook can actually look at your face.
I don't like
all
that.
All right, guys. Well, the movie has made more than $800 million worldwide, which may make Wonder Woman's paycheck seem pretty small. Actress Gal Gadot apparently got a salary of $300,000 to play the superhero. Industry experts expect Gal will get big bonuses tied to the film's success. Still, does this sound right, Tom? $300,000?
I think when you're one of the major stars of a movie, you can negotiate a contract that will include a percentage of the final gross. And if she has, like, and I think James Cameron did this with Titanic, remember,
right.
and ended up making a gazillion dollars
right.
on that. So if she has, like, a good percentage at the end, she's going to come out great.
But the point is, she's not a major star. Well, she is now,
she wasn't.
Right? So the market, come on, are we going to regulate everything?
I think the guy that played Captain America had the same deal. He only got $300,000.
And now he can get a better contract.
Yeah, the word is sequel.
Yeah, that's true.
You're only worth what someone will pay you. And that's what she was offered. And she had an agent, I'm assuming. They signed the contract. If she gets a percentage, great. Yes, we're making something out of nothing. She is worth more now.
Right.
Yep.
Good job. Way to go.
Because, like, you made $12 when you first started on radio, right? Now you're worth $13.
And that was a day. $12 a day. So, yeah, no, you're exactly right. You have to prove yourself, and she did.
I thought it was a year.
She is now. All right.
Media doesn't pay.
We will get ready for something. Guys, thank you very much.
Thank you, Alex.